cool with the cloud racing by. 36 years we've been out here doing the same thing every year. This year we visited 11 glaciers. And of the 36, this will probably be the second, maybe the third worst in terms of glacier melt. And when the glaciers melt, it's not just about the glaciers. I mean, here we are standing on the approach route. And what we can see is there's stress in the vegetation. A lot of heather was stressed out up where we were camped. On the other hand, the polywogs are really happy. There's tons of polywogs in all the little ponds. So this year, what we saw was a relatively weak winter, leaving us with about 70% of our normal snowfall, followed by an early melt season in the spring. And it's not that summer has been exceptionally hot, but it's just been long. And so that combination is going to mean 2 meters approximately of each glacier just melted away. And if your glaciers are averaging 40 meters thick, obviously, that's 5% of the volume of ice in the North Cascades. It's going to be lost this year alone. So obviously you can't sustain year after year like this. Unfortunately, 2015 was even worse. 2016, 17, and 18 weren't as bad, but still there was substantial losses. And so, you know, this pattern continues. The North Cascades aren't unique. Every year the story's a little different, but the Alps are going to have a worse year this year. And so we look forward to continuing to tell this story year after year of how some of these glaciers are disappearing. The Iceberg Glacier that we were visiting up here had very little snow cover left, a new ice cliff into a small new lake, and that's going to help make it disappear even sooner.
So this is my 11th consecutive year coming out to this spot, and I think for me to see how each season or each summer responds to the changes has been super interesting. And so this year we've had, or there's been a wetter spring and summer out here, and so you can see how well that's done for the little pond ecosystems and for the wildflowers and the kind of almost little super blooms like you've had in other parts of the country. But additionally, because it's still been a poor winter and still had plenty of heat in the summer, the amount of blue ice on the glaciers is the worst I've seen since 2015. And what's most striking is just the way the character of each of the glaciers change. And I think of them as each a key component for this ecosystem, and then further down the line for humans in this area for a water resource. And so just looking at the surface of the glaciers and seeing the major changes, whether there's just water cascading over all of the blue ice, forming kind of slush and just causing higher rates of melt than on the snow, and also the formation of a lot of new little melt ponds. We saw really a new big pond formed at the bottom of Iceworm Glacier, which is a little ways behind me this year. And so seeing those types of changes and which glaciers are going to persist in this climate and which aren't has been really interesting, and shocked by the changes that I've seen. This year I tried to do a lot of painting, and I was trying to capture some of the major changes that I saw. And so, for example, at this location at working at Iceworm Glacier, I was capturing the new pond that formed and the way the whole terminus of the glacier was kind of collapsing into that pond and falling apart. And then another location on Coleman Glacier, Mount Baker, I tried to capture this big mass of bedrock that was kind of splitting apart the glacier, kind of separating its flow, and had emerged a few years ago. Painting is a good way to just sit and observe a landscape, and it's taught me over the years to like notice those like major changes and want to try to kind of capture them as a snapshot.